Hello, good evening to all of you. I am Dr. Paramapalli Surendra Upadhyay speaking from Delhi with my grandchild Mr. Siddhanta Rao. Okay, he is studying in 4th standard in Birla Vidyaniketan School of Delhi and he is aged just 10 years and he is showing all the interest in astrology. That's why I want to give my all the knowledge to this fellow so long as he is very interested in learning astrology. Yes, Mr. Siddhanta, can you start with this part? 5, isn't it? Part 5, yes. That is monthly prediction for March 2018. Okay, we are uploading right now only for March 2018 prediction we are giving. This is from 16th March 2018. Yes, Mr. Siddhanta, tell.
In the Rashi chart of 16th March 2018, Ascendant along with Sun, Mercury and Venus are in Pisces. Rahu is in Cancer. Jupiter in retrograde in Libra. Saturn and Mars are in Sagittarius. Ketu is in Capricorn and Moon is in Aquarius.
Here one thing I wanted to tell you, you can see here on 16th March Moon is in Aquarius and Sun, Mars and Venus are in Pisces. Now on 17th March, that is next day, this is actually 16th March is in the morning sunrise period. This is in Bangalore 6:29 AM. At 6:29 PM, okay, 6:29 PM or 6:16 PM on 17th March, Moon is moving to Pisces and forming Amavasya. Okay, it is, you can see here. Now he is going to give prediction about Mesha Rashi. Yes, Mesha Rashi.
Sun, Venus, Mercury, all in house of expenditure and losses. Hence, for Mesha Rashi people, this is the time to go abroad. Spouse is responsible for the cause of lord of house and of spouse. Venus is in exaltation mode. Moon is in house of profit and next day it will join Sun and cause Purnima, full moon day. For Aryans, Bhagya is affected by Saturn and Mars. Jupiter is in house of Kalatra and hence the relationship with the their spouse will be good only. Their house happiness is occupied by Rahu and hence there may be vigorous movement in the Karatvas of 4th house. Vrishabha Rashi people are having edge over Aryans in respect of house of profit. They are benefited by relatives and friends, ladies, father, boss and government.
Why I am telling this ladies, father, boss, government? You know that Venus represents ladies, Sun represents father, and Sun represent boss, Sun represent government. That is why I am telling. Suppose Moon is there, that means I used to tell mother. Okay? So continue, Mr. Siddhanta.
On 17 March 2018 at 1:21 PM, Moon also will be joining Sun in Mina Rashi and forming new moon day on Saturday. Pisces people may be having land related problem on property related problem. Vrishabha Rashi people will be having smooth professional careers as Moon at present in Aquarius since Jupiter in Libra aspects through its fifth drashti on Kumbha. There will be Gajakesari yoga form and hence the native of Taurus will be benefited with sweet news from the professional front also. Their children are doing good in their educational front as well as in foreign front also. Mithuna Rashi people will be enjoying good news from their professional front as one type of Raja Yoga form in 10th house of Pisces. Their Bhagya will be going up in view of Gajakesari Yoga form in Rashi Kumbha due to Jupiter's fifth aspect on Moon in
Satavisha Nakshatra Charan 3.
Purva Punya Sthan of Mithuna Rashi people are good and hence their children will be doing well at their higher studies. However, their Kalatra front is not good as both Saturn and Mars are in Sagittarius. Karka Rashi. They are mentally sick as long as Rahu in their Rashi. However, their Dhana Dipati Sun in their Bhagya Sthan. Hence, what more they want? That too along with Venus, debilitated Mercury and Sun is positive. Even
Chaturthadipati and Labhadipati Venus
also posited in House of Prophet. In fact, for Karkans, it is really a golden period. March 16, 17 and 18 will be reaping of gold in their life period. I believe only problems with the Karkans are that the relationship with their spouse is very sad. It is not at all good. Their house happiness is having Jupiter, and hence they may go to the new house or new rental house. Simha Rashi. These Leo people are having excellent communication. Their financial lord Mercury is debilitated in Pisces and are with Sun, Venus and on 17th and 18th with Moon also. So it is somewhat mixed results. Their children may not be good in education as Saturn and Mars are posited in Sagittarius. The relationship with their spouse will be sweet since their house of profit is debilitated.
They may face somewhat mixed results here also. Kanya Rashi.
For Kanya Rashi people, since Jupiter is posited in second house, there will be no dearth for the finance. For them, house of happiness as Saturn and Mars may give unhappiness. Ketu in fifth house makes their children frustrating. Kalatra of Kanya Rashi having Sun, Venus and Mercury making them beauty, ruling oriented and witty. Moon in 6th house making them prone to cough and cold and also lung related diseases. House of Profit is occupied by Rahu making sudden surge in profit. Tula Rashi. They are very sober in nature as Jupiter is in Libra. 2nd house and 7th lord Mars with Saturn causing some hurdles in Kutumba and Manasthana and also in Kalatra San. 4th house is occupied by Ketu, making the native unhappy. A moon occupying 5th house, causing their children happiness. 6th house is occupied by Sun, Venus and Mercury, making them healthy. Bhagya Lord Mercury in 6th house, making his Bhagya gone to Dasthan. Professional house is occupied by Rahu, making his professional volatile. House of Prophet Lord Sun in 6th means his profit has gone to diseases. Vrishchika Rashi. Vrishchika Rashi people will spend money for their religious activities and also for visiting temples. Their Kutumba Sthana as well as Dhana Sthana is occupied by Saturn and Mars making some hurdles in these Karakatvas. Moon in 4th house making their mother happy and also are blessed with vehicles and good house environment. 5th house is occupied by Sun, Venus and Mercury making their children happy. 7th house, Lord Venus in 5th house making their Kalatra will be happy after the marriage. They are blessed with sudden Bhagya in view of Rahu in 9th house. Their professional Lord Sun in 5th house indicating their professional brings happiness. Sagittarius, their happiness is now par excellence. The relationship with the spouse may be too good. Your personality may be having angry nature because of Mars as it lords and also may be a bit slow due to the presence of Saturn in the Rashi. Your professional front is the cause for your happiness as the Lord Mercury is with exalted Venus, Sun and of course from 17th and 18th March with the Moon also as full Moon will be taken place. They are present in your 4th house causing happy environment in both professional as well as in your family front also. However, because of Saturn's 10th aspect as well as Mercury being weak in Pisces may cause some ulta results.
You thought in the mind may not be materializing. Your profit will be up in view of Jupiter in Libra. You are having beautiful communication due to the presence of Moon in 3rd house for the day and may be changing on 17th and 18th month once Moon moves to Pisces. Okay? And Capricorn, your expenditure and tensions during this period may be much more than as usual. You may be benefited by your mother as Moon is posited in your Moola Trikona house in Kumbha Rashi. You may be expecting good news from your boss as Jupiter is posited in 10th house. Relationship with your spouse may be strained. One, as Kalatra with the Moon will be aspected by a third aspect of transit Saturn from Sagittarius. Your marketing efforts will be doubled and people will be happy because of your effective communications. Business and Mercury as well as Venus are together in Pisces and on 17th March